you are also down 22,000. How's the still hilltop? And hilltop's still going up in value, so yeah. I think we will get the truck chain, so I'm going to drive into the yard, do the turnaround, and fill up on the way out. We can stop by the workshop and just replace the rear axle like you do. Come on, tractor, you made it. Thank you. Of course, one thing I need to be aware of when I'm driving with a steerable rear axle is having a tractor follow me is possibly going to be a little bit of a challenge. Because the ability of the tractor to follow the truck will be, oh geez, and there you go. That might be the problem that all the workers were having. Highly possible that the worker will crash into the gatepost. Nope, he made it. Okay. You go. Okay, the workshop is just up here. And looks like the tractor got stuck on something, so... Ooh. Okay, truck customize. Wheel setup, steering axle. Yeah. So another 2,800 on the price. And the tipper just fell off. Okay, reconnect the tipper. Start the engine. So now we have the trailing axle on the truck. He's also steering. That might help with our issues so far. Let's get this guy down there as well. I was considering getting another 30,000 litre trailer for the class. So 116 minus 30 is 86. It's going to be everybody and one thing. So we're going to have 13,000 after the next load. I actually actually, trucks not having so much of a problem with this hill. That's some nice looking stuff. Honestly, don't recall what I planted here. This the spell? No, rye. Maybe rye. Canola. Okay. Oh, that's right. These were the spelt fields, so we've cycled them over to an oil seed. I was meaning to plant sunflowers here. Unfortunately, I had oilseed radish in the fields, and I ploughed it in during the fall, which would have meant leaving the fields fallow over the winter. So I figured we'll plant the canola, and oilseed radish some other fields instead for the winter months. All our fields during these months have something growing in them. And if they don't have a cash crop, then we're looking at the other stuff. Oilseed radish for a while. Okay, swing wide, bring us around. Yeah. I don't know, I think there is something to be said for having the steering rear axle. Just a thought. Plonk that in there and stop the worker. And the worker hit the wall. Well, we tried. Dude, you kind of missed. Try and get that lined up again. Whoa, that's just bad. All right, come on. Third time's a charm. And we are in and good. The truck out. Absolutely. Okay, steering wheel axle, good for this. Oh, wrong way again. You're out of there. 930. So I think we should be. Ooh, that's cool. Or a bunch. I don't know. It's a thing. We can probably turn our blinky lights off for now. So one more double load and then a partial. This time we'll just load and then do the swing around at the end. Now, this will do 86,000 in two loads. I'm not sure how much we actually have in the silo right now. But since we have to go out again, if it'll contain, or if the truck will take it twice, everything, then might skip taking the tractor out. Any minute now we should get a great demand for barley or spelt, because that's always a fun thing. 86,272, okay. So I can't fit everything into the truck. We'd have 272 litres left over at the end. So we're taking the tractor with us too. Okay, wait till he's at 30,000. We'll take another trip up to Hilltop, I guess. Yep, Hilltop's still best price. Since it's only 10:30, I could take the semi-truck back to the store. And then really it's just a matter of figuring out all the other attachments for this thing. Might be a slurry tank that I haven't looked up for. I guess I could race up this hill. Yay. Power. Or not. Just trundle up this hill at a leisurely pace. And then wait for the Challenger to catch up to us. Good. Let's check the store for slurry tanks. So I'm just looking for stuff that moves slurry. Alpine farming pack. Oh, didn't know I had that. 90,000 litre, I could use that better than I could use the one I've got. I think we've got this one, which is 55. I don't know what the difference between those two is. Oh, okay. Then we got a couple of semis. Yeah. Nothing. Let's look here at man stuff. We just got those trucks. Okay. Back and lizard stuff. Actually a lot of lizard stuff. I should probably have not bothered with that. Liquid tank transports water and milk. Liquid tank transports diesel. So So these two are the trailers for the truck we now have. Tank swap. Ah! Oh. And that does carry everything. So is there an XL vote? Yes, there is. 31,000. So we can buy that and transport stuff in it. Timber frame wings. And then that's just a grain tank. Okay, I'm good with that. I don't know where it's hiding, but. What did I just buy? Hello, what did I just buy? Where the 2,800 pounds of new equipment happened. Oops. I guess we'll find out. Anyway, let's stop messing around. I can transport slurry. I think my current slurry tank's only 30,000, or the one we just sold was only 30,000. So the attachment for the back of this will do two loads, which is good. Or $1,000, yeah, 1,000 liters more, which is good. Let's get in here as quick as I can. Empty. Switch off the worker and little bit too far. Swing that back end over. Try not to knock my fence down. I think I've done good. Barely. Ooh, just. Okay, we'll turn this thing around. Yeah, I guess I didn't done good. Let's get this in the tipping area like that. Right in, and we are good to go. So, what else do we have to sell now? 13,272. I think we're down to just the potatoes and the sugar beets. Oh, and the sunflowers. Potatoes, sugar beets, and sunflowers. Barley, sunflowers. So, sunflowers best on the first of spring. Potatoes in 2 days' time. Sugar beets in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days' time. So, I like that there is a gap between shipping the potatoes and shipping the sugar beets, because having to ship them all on the same day would be frustrating because there's so much. I have been extolling the virtues of sugar beets and potatoes when it comes to value of crop. Now, obviously, when you plant two big fields of triticale or spelt, your income from those two big fields is going to be bigger than the income from one small field of potatoes or sugar beets. But if you plant fields that are the same size, you will get serious amounts of sugar beets and potatoes off a field. And for example, I think our first sugar beet harvest was 1.5 million liters of sugar beet, and we made tons of money on that. So definitely, it was a good choice to plant them and harvest them. From an income point of view, it was a pain in the butt digging them out the ground and shipping them off to the store. I think that's the main reason why I had the semi trailer, because I had so many to ship. It was just, I want the biggest thing I can find that will take potatoes or sugar beets. Okay, let's load that up with the last of it. And actually, you don't have to park quite so close. Drive you down to the end, turn you round, park you to the side, because we're going to need you in a couple of days for the root crop sales. Like I said, we are just shy of £1 million. Which is good. Now, I suppose what I could do, I'll park this here. I could go to the store with the two trucks. I just cycled through everything. Ugh, there. We are still looking at Hilltop, maybe. Triticale. And Hilltop's still the best. Simply the best. And decide, do I want a long bed trailer for this setup? I mean, I'm kind of thinking, if I was going to Hilltop stores, I do not want a trailer on the back of this. But hauling animals down to the animal dealer, because it's on the other side of the map, being able to do it at approximately 50 animals per trip, that's a good deal, because we're going to be selling hundreds. Check to see whether our our sheep are doing anything. Still got a while before the wool starts coming in. As soon as that starts happening, that's another thing that is going to be quite a lot of caretaking involved. Fortunately, I found an auto-load wool trailer, so it's not very big, but it does let me get the wool off the spawn point fairly quickly. What's that? 9,900. We are not there. Oh, okay. Gonna take this back to the yard. We'll detach the shell. And then I think we'll probably lead the other truck to the store. I will start buying bits for the back of it. May buy a trailer? I don't know. That's such a decision. I think the trailer might be useful. And the trailer can be hauled behind a tractor too, so there's that as well. I should probably shut that gate now. We're finished driving through it. Okay. And I remember back on Lawfolds, we actually had two trucks of this style. And then we had two of each rear body that we could use for moving stuff around. So a couple of things we've got. We've got those wall bales or pallets to the side, which are actually, I think, 32,000 litres of wall per pallet. And then I've also got, as I said, an auto load trailer. Which I can use to pull more. Okay. No, back up. So one problem with the AR frames is you can't really steer while you're picking them up or putting them down. But as you can see from these, without the AR, so without the hook lift equipment, you've still got a rigid frame here, which is going to raise the level of the bed higher than a normal tipper, but you don't have, and similarly with the hook lift, but the chassis does not have the heavy lifting equipment. Excuse me. Ugh. Drive down to here. We will grab that. Jump back in this and we'll head to the store. Okay, I think the decision is made. I am going to buy a trailer for the back of this. Bob seems to be having some issues. Nope, here it comes. Okay. Let's get rolling before he crashes into the back of my nice new truck. I think both these trucks have approximately the same top speed. Unfortunately, the traffic does not. And Bob's caught up to us. Let's go. So I do like the whole thing. There's a new mod on FarmSim 22 that allows you to limit the number of workers. The minimum 6, though. and it's split evenly between male and female workers, and you can give them names, and you can change how much you pay them as a group. You can have overtime rates, so if they work past 5 o'clock before 10, you can give them 20% extra, 30% extra, and if they work past 10 through to 5 o'clock in the morning, you can give them double pay or something like that. So that's kind of cool. I like the idea of naming them, although on the map they still appear as worker ABC, I think, or not at all. And